What's up, everyone? It's DigiTamer Joel back to talk about a deck that I've been personally excited about ever since EX2 dropped. This was going to be kind of a first look talk about a deck that was probably high tier 2, maybe even tier 1.5, but about 10 minutes before recording this video, I found out that this deck actually got first place at the Saturday Ultimate Cup, and that means that you guys know I'm talking about Green Hybrid from EX2 with Rapidmon, of course. Green Hybrid has been a little bit overshadowed in BT8 because Rapidmon, which is probably the best green card that's been printed since Nidhoggmon, has pretty much been monopolized by the yellow hybrid deck. Rapidmon, of course, being a green-yellow Digimon. But with the additional Terriermon support in EX2, Rapidmon is now very easily slottable into a green hybrid deck and brings a lot of really powerful synergy along with it. Not to mention the green hybrid strategy itself being pretty powerful into the EX2 meta right now. So I'm going to go ahead and talk about the deck, how to play the deck, some core combos, some deck or card synergies that you may not have intuitively understood upon first looking at the cards. And then I'm going to go over my personal deck list and then also show you guys some example gameplay of how powerful this deck can be if you high roll or even just like a normal standard grind out game going back and forth. This deck is very powerful, can definitely compete with tier 1 stuff. And yeah, we're going to go ahead and talk about everything there is to know about Green Hybrid. Debuting in BT7, Green Hybrid was a deck that was unfortunately overshadowed by its yellow, blue, red, and even purple counterparts. All the other hybrid colors had much more consistent tops and top table showings at events. And unfortunately, Green Hybrid was kind of left in this sort of nebulous mid-range status where you could kind of go aggressive with it if you're running red base with Atomic Inferno, or you can instead choose to run green base and try to play a more consistent control-based style. And unfortunately, moving into the BT8 format, not much has really changed, with both yellow and blue remaining top table contenders, as well as red hybrid OTK still being a very powerful threat. Of course, purple did kind of fall to the wayside, and green unfortunately did join it there. Not really many people were talking about Green Hybrid in BT8. But with the addition of the new EX2 Terriermon support, Green Hybrid has gained a lot of powerful tools, mainly two cards that have definitely increased the value of the deck, increased the synergy of the cards within the deck. And I am, of course, talking about number one, the new Gummimon Egg, which allows you to draw a card every time one of your opponent's Digimon is suspended on your turn. Of course, this has huge synergy with the Green Hybrid strategy, which has a lot of cards that can suspend your opponent's Digimon for very low cost, namely Metal Kabuterimon, which can suspend for one memory, Thunder Laser, which can suspend for one memory, and of course Armor Rapidmon itself, which can cost as little to two or even one memory within the Green Hybrid ecosystem. And we'll talk about how that is possible once I get to the card combinations and synergies. So yes, Gummimon is a very powerful card within Green Hybrid, allowing you to draw cards within the deck's inherent playstyle, which is one of the biggest problems Green has had historically, is its lack of draw power and consistency. Green is one of the worst decks to brick with just because you have no draw power to get yourself out of that. But Gummimon does help alleviate that situation and is definitely the best generic egg printed for the color so far. And the second card that is an excellent addition to the Green Hybrid deck introduced in EX2 is, of course, the regular level 3 EX2 Terriermon, whose effect says that whenever you play a Tamer from your hand while it's face up on your board, you can increase your memory by 1. Reducing the cost of all your Tamers in a hybrid deck is, of course, a very powerful effect. And the Terriermon also has a pretty useful inheritable in that it grants the Digimon it is under plus 2000 DP. Anytime when your opponent's Digimon becomes suspended, this synergizes very well with Armor Rapidmon itself, who can then become an 8000 DP beater when it comes out on the board and pretty much run over or trade with any of your opponent's 13000 DP or less Digimon. Very powerful effect. And it's also just another solid Terriermon name, since Armor Rapidmon can digivolve over Terriermons for 3 instead of 4, giving you access to another really good Terriermon that also synergizes with the rest of the Green Hybrid deck, is a huge boon to the strategy and something that is definitely not to be overlooked. So if you weren't sure about Green Hybrid, or maybe you didn't know that this was now a real meta contender, now hopefully with the addition of these 3 new cards and explaining how they work in the ecosystem, you guys are definitely considering the deck. And not to mention, it did get first place at the Ultimate Cup that just happened earlier today at the time of recording. So I'm going to go ahead and go over some of the core synergies of the deck right now, and that way hopefully you guys get a better idea of how the deck operates and how to play the deck for yourself. All right, guys, so I'm going to start off with probably one of the most powerful combos or plays that you can make within this deck. All you need for your starting position is a Izzy from the starter deck face up on your board. You need a Terriermon EX2 and Raising with a Gummimon underneath, ideally, but this can pretty much be any egg in the green color that you choose. So we're starting off our turn with two memory. We can go ahead and raise up our Terriermon. We digivolve into Rapidmon for 3 with its effect, which digivolves for 3 over Terriermons instead of its standard 4 cost. So that'll cost 3 memory. We suspend one of their Digimon because we do have a Tamer on our side of the board. And then when we suspend one of their opponent's Digimon, we can tap the Izzy to gain a memory, so we go back to 0. And then because we suspended one of our opponent's Digimon, we can draw a card from Gummimon. And then our Terriermon gain, or our Rapidmon gains 2000 DP from our Terriermon's inheritable effect. So this is now an 8000 DP Digimon. This is the play I alluded to where you can make Rapidmon cost 2 or even 1. So if you have multiple copies of Izzy Azumi out on your board, then you can make this cost even less. So obviously you can now clear your opponent's board, clear like their 5000 DP Digimon or less, and then swing at anything that had 13000 DP or less, because it now loses 5000 DP, effectively making 8000 DP. Rapidmon is now 8000 DP, so you can trade into it and then armor purge or just run over it if it's stronger. This is one of the best plays in the deck, and because people are used to playing against yellow hybrid with Rapidmon, where Rapidmon can really realistically only come out for 4 memory, and then you can gain the memory back if you have the starter deck Patamon or if you have Cody. For this in green hybrid, you can bring out Rapidmon for 2, which is absolutely insane. And then we're going to talk about the synergies that the deck has with the rest of the hybrid package. Alright guys, so now we're going to talk about one of the more high roll plays that you can make with this deck. So in this scenario, you are starting your turn with a Mimi and JP already established on your board, and you have either a Bokomon or a green memory boost, but in this case we're going to use Bokomon just for example's sake. So you start off your turn at 3 memory thanks to Mimi. You're going to go ahead and hatch into a Gummimon, digivolve it into your EX2 Terriermon. You're going to draw a card for digivolve. Then you're going to want a Beetlemon, digivolve it over JP for 1. You're going to draw and then use Beetlemon's effect. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, we're just going to add the Rhino just for why not. Put the rest at the bottom. Bokomon will gain us 2 memories, so we'll go back to 4. We're going to digivolve into the Rhino. We had one in our hand already, and we also added one from the search. So we'll go ahead and digivolve into the Rhino for 1. Draw. We now have a level 5 green Digimon out on our side of the board, so we can activate Mimi to tap the Mimi. We can then digivolve our Rapidmon into Terriermon for 3. We will draw, suspend one of their Digimon, draw a card for suspending one of their Digimon, and then Rapidmon now becomes 8000 DP. And here we can choose to either swing in with the Rapidmon and the Bokomon first, or we can swing in with the Rhino over their newly suspended Digimon from Rapidmon's effect and use the effect to go into Ancient Beetle for 3 and trash top card of their security and then do a piercing check over the suspended Digimon. So it just depends on how aggressive you want to be, how you're feeling out the situation of the play. But in this scenario, you can do up to 5 damage, 4 damage. Or you can do 2 damage if you just want to play it safe. So it really depends. Anywhere from 2 to 4 damage you can make with this play. Obviously, you did need a little bit of setup, but it's not uncommon to have this board set up in the green hybrid deck, especially my build where I do run 4 Bokomon and 4 green memory boosts just to eke out the extra memory to be able to Mimi, bring out the Terriermon, and then Rapidmon and still have it be your turn. And lastly, I would be remiss if I didn't talk about one of the most powerful late game bombs this deck is capable of. I'm of course talking about the 0 cost to play Susanoomon. For this play, all you need is 7 hybrids or tamers in your trash, a Bokomon out of your board, and any tamer that you have at your disposal. Go ahead and activate Hidden Potential Discovered. Tap your Bokomon. You can then digivolve Susanoomon over your tamer, in this case JP, but it can be any tamer. Unfortunately, JP doesn't further reduce the cost by 1, since it only reduces green Digimon's cost by 1. Susanoomon is white, so that doesn't work. But HPD does allow you to reduce the cost of Susanoomon by 5, so it costs 2. Return 7 cards, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 from your trash to your deck. And then the Pokemon will gain you 2 memory because you digivolved over a Tamer. So boom, you go to 0. You can go ahead and now delete one of your opponent's Digimon and swing for 3 checks, all for 0 memory. So this is the biggest bomb this deck has available to it. Yes, you do have to give up 2 slots for HPT and Susanomon, which traditionally the Green Hybrid deck has not played these cards because they weren't really useful. But I think that just as a huge 2 card combo play that can come out of nowhere and just win you a game, literally, because you can do it for 0 memory with a Pokemon or even a green memory boost, just anything that can get you that extra 2 memory you need, this play is absolutely huge. I run it in my deck just because why not? I mean, if you can steal a game with this for only 2 card investment in your deck, then why not? And HPD comes in handy in other situations. And Susanomon itself, you can just digivolve it over your Ancient Beetlemon or your Spent Nidhogg, and it's still a high value card. And even just late game as a card that can refuel your deck so you don't deck out, or against yellow hybrid or control matchups where you're going to go to like last 10 cards of your deck, Susanomon is a huge bomb card in and of itself. So yeah, so those are pretty much like the 3 kind of standard plays to look out for. This HPD Susanomon play isn't really standard, it's more of like a bomb play, but the Terriermon stuff, the Rapidmon stuff is definitely stuff you should look out for. Plays that weren't available to you in past versions of Green Hybrid that now you can certainly pull off and pull off very strongly. So then we're just going to go ahead and get into my deck list so you guys can see exactly what I'm running in my deck. And if you guys want to copy my list, sure. And then I'm also going to go over some tech card examples that I'm not running that are certainly viable in the deck and that you could choose to run if you want to, if it suits your playstyle. All right, so let's go ahead and get into the deck list. Number one, starting off with the eggs, of course, you have to run 4 Gummimon. This is the best egg in the deck. And then for your 5th egg option, you have a choice between either Argomon or Pinomon. Pinomon will additionally let you draw a card whenever you attack one of your opponent's suspended Digimon. Notably, you don't have to delete the Digimon, you simply have to declare the attack into it. So this comes useful in situations where you're maybe trading or even just to sacrifice your Digimon into one of their suspended Digimon if you need the draw really badly. And Argomon on your unsuspend phase, when the Digimon it's underneath becomes unsuspended, you gain a memory. This has pretty high synergy with Armor Rapidmon as it is more likely to live through the opponent's turn. Just giving you that extra 1 memory at the start of your turn can definitely always come in handy, especially in a deck like Green Hybrid, which can make very much use of that 1 memory thanks to all the 1 memory plays you have available in your deck. The rookies, these are pretty much the only rookies in my opinion you should be playing. 4 of the BT3 Terriermon, the memory blocker. I have the alt art showcased here, but of course the regular art is nothing to scoff at, still the same card. And the EX2 Terriermon is of course one of the best new additions to the deck, has high synergy thanks to its ability where whenever you play a green tamer you can gain 1 memory, and its inheritable is no slouch either, especially under Armor Rapidmon itself. And then we choose to play 4 Pokemon. Pokemon is kind of the bridge that allows you to extend your plays thanks to that 2 memory gain whenever you digivolve over your tamer, in addition to being able to search out your pieces, including your tamers, your ancient Beetlemon, your ancient Troymon, or any of your green hybrid cards. So Pokemon, obviously, an incredible card in any hybrid deck, and I choose to run 4 of it here because of its ability to be able to gain a memory in the green hybrid deck as opposed to other hybrid decks where you only break even off its effect, because JP lets you reduce cost by 1, letting your level 4 hybrids cost 1 memory. Pokemon gains you 2 memory, netting you a 1 memory gain for digivolving is pretty strong. And then we have our full hybrid package, so 4 Beetlemon, 4 Metal Kabuki Terriermon. This needs no explanation. 4 Armor Rapidmon, this is the best card in the deck. There, you don't really have a way of searching it since you're not playing the search Terriermon, so playing 4 is the best way to ensure that you draw it, and this is a card that you really always want to see in your hand regardless, and so we play 4. For level 5s, we are playing our 4 Rhino Kabuki Terriermon, which is standard in the Green Hybrid build. This is like the linchpin of your deck. This is the card that lets you digivolve for 1 over your level 4s if they have a Tamer in their source. And then you can use the effect to digivolve into your Ancient Beetle, Ancient Troy, or Shivamon for only 3 memory instead of their standard digivolution cost. So this lets you turbo into level 6 very, very quickly, in addition to it being an 8,000 DP beat stick, which actually gets over a lot of the meta level 5s right now. So even just having a Rhino Kabuki Terriermon on its own and just sitting on it can be a pretty powerful card. So Rhino Kabuki Terriermon at 4 is mandatory. And then we are, of course, running our one copy of Blossomon for the Digisorption, allowing us to, you know, have that extra level 5 that we may find ourselves needing, in addition to be able to pull off some pretty good Nidhogg plays in the deck. Of course, the Blossomon Nidhogg is a very powerful play that extends all the way back to BT4 meta, and really, most of us don't need any introduction to that play. For level 6s, you do have some play here. I'm choosing to run 3 Ancient Beetles, 1 Nidhogg, and 1 Ancient Troy. The reason for not running 4 Ancient Beetles is just for space. If I could run 4, I would, but I needed to make room for some other cards in the deck. And then for level 6s, I choose the 1 Nidhogg and 1 Ancient Troymon. Nidhogg, because in combination with Rapidmon, you can suspend any of your opponent's Digimon, climb to level 5, and then play the Nidhogg to botech their whole board. Very powerful play, especially if you have the Blossomon out. So this is definitely a play to consider. Ancient Troymon, because it will buy you some time against the more aggressive decks in the meta, such as Imperial Dramon, of course, which it pretty much nullifies all their multi-attack plays if you have Troymon out on your board. And the other level 6 that you could choose to play that I do see some people playing is Shivamon. Shivamon can digivolve from Rhino Kabuterimon with Rhino Kabuterimon's effect, because it is an insectoid type Digimon. It is a very powerful floodgate in that it prevents your opponent from using options if all your Digimon and your board are suspended. This is a little bit more difficult of a condition to meet in a green hybrid deck as opposed to a pure Shivamon deck, which has cards which can suspend themselves to activate effects, whereas in green hybrid you're pretty much forced to attack in order to suspend your own Digimon, which does pose a risk in and of itself. However, the floodgate effect sometimes is worth it. And of course, the effect to trash your top card of your opponent's security during your unsuspend phase when you unsuspend is powerful. In my opinion, it is a slower version of Ancient Beetlemon, who can trash the top card of your opponent's security by simply attacking and deleting one of your opponent's Digimon. They do have slightly different niches, but for my money, I believe Ancient Beetlemon is the more proactive and better card, and I would value a fourth copy of Ancient Beetle over a one tech copy of Shivamon in my list in particular. But if you are a Shivamon fan and you choose to maybe play it over the Nidhogg and or the Ancient Troymon, then go ahead and be my guest. There's no reason not to. For my level 7 slot, I do play my one copy of Susanamon in conjunction with my one copy of Hidden Potential in order to potentially pull off that bomb play like I described earlier. And these cards in and of themselves are useful cards. Susanamon for its ability to recycle your deck late game. You can even just hard digivolve it over one of your level 6s if you just need that deletion and security pressure. It has a large 15,000 TP body both on your board and in your security. So overall, Susanamon as a one card investment in your deck I think is worthwhile. Moving on to tamers, I do run a pretty reduced tamer count in my deck. In this case, I am running 4 JPs, which I think is the most mandatory tamer in the deck because it allows you to reduce your hybrid cost by 1, which really enables the turbo playstyle of green hybrid. 3 Mimi Tachikawa, because it is just the best green tamer in my opinion, being able to cheese out your rookies from your raising area for that extra attack, or even just turboing through your rookies. And if you have 2 Mimis out on the board, that's your free extra attack every turn, which is super powerful. Mimi is one of the most game-winning tamers in the game, in my opinion. And then I run 2 copies of Izzy Izumi from the starter deck, which is whenever one of your opponent's Digimon becomes suspended on your turn, you can tap it to gain a memory. This is just a solid play extender, in addition to being a 2-cost tamer, which makes it a very easy commit. And if you have a EX2 Terriermon on the board, this becomes a 1-cost tamer, which enables some pretty strong choke plays by being able to pass turn with only one memory by playing Izzy. And then for the last 6 cards of my deck, I'm running 3 Green Memory Boost, 2 Thunder Laser, and the 1 Hidden Potential Discovered, as previously mentioned. Green Memory Boost is kind of the bridge between the hybrid and the Rapidmon engines in this deck, as it allows you to search out any piece, in addition to being able to delay to gain that 2 memory. This is a play extender in the same vein as Bokomon. In my opinion, you could easily run 3 Bokomon and 4 Memory Boost, or like I'm doing it for Bokomon, 3 Memory Boost. If I had the room, I would run 4 of each. For example, I would maybe consider cutting the Blossomon if I find myself not really needing level 5s, or potentially even cutting the HPD and Susano if I choose not to run that Hyrule 2-card bomb combo that opens up 2 additional slots in my deck. But for what it's worth, I do think it's worth including in the deck, so I keep it in and I leave the memory boost at 2. And finally, two Thunder Lasers, just because it's a very powerful option. It allows you to control your opponent's board for only one memory and enables all your effects which suspend your opponent's Digimon and which require you to attack over your opponent's Digimon, such as the Ancient Beetlemon. And the last three cards I have listed here, the Ken, the Shiumon, and the Climmon, are just additional techs that I don't run in my main deck that you could choose to run if you wanted to. You could play Ken in place of one of your Mimis, as its effect does come up in this deck by whenever you delete one of your opponent's Digimon in battle, you can tap the Ken to gain a memory. It's a pretty solid play extender, but in my opinion, I would rather be winning the game with the effect of Mimi than simply extending my play by one memory with the effect of Ken, which is why I choose not to run it. But if it works for you, then it's still a good card. It's still synergizes with the deck, so you're more than welcome to play it. And the last card I want to highlight is Climbmon from BT8. What this Digimon does is on Digivolution, if it is suspended, then you can bounce one of your opponent's Digimon with DP less than Climbmon. I want to highlight this card because of its synergy with Armor Rapidmon. So Rapidmon, when it comes out, it'll decrease three of your opponent's Digimon by minus 5,000 DP. And then if you have the EX2 Terriermon underneath it, you will increase the Rapidmon's DP by 2,000. And then you can attack with that Rapidmon. It's likely to live, either attacking over one of your opponent's Digimon or attacking into security. And then you can Digivolve your suspended Rapidmon into Climbmon, which will now have 10,000 DP thanks to the boost from the EX2 Terriermon. And then you can suspend any of your opponent's Digimon with 10,000 DP or less, which is pretty much going to be all of them, considering that Rapidmon decreased their DP by 5,000. So with this combination, Climbmon can theoretically bounce a 15,000 DP Digimon back to your opponent's hand. That's a very, very powerful effect. Of course, in this scenario, the Climbmon would be taking the place of the Blossommon. So you are trading the consistency of Blossommon being able to Digizorb and Digivolve it for free to either draw yourself an extra card in a pinch or enable a powerful Nidhogg play for the effect of Climbmon, which can potentially remove a really large nuisance on your side, on your opponent's side of the board, and be able to break a board that maybe Blossom or Nidhoggmon on their own wouldn't be able to do. All right, guys, so that's my deck list. Again, the Ken Shiumon and Climbmon at the end are not actually part of the deck. They're just some tech choices that I wanted to highlight. But for the rest of my deck, I think it's pretty solid. I've been playing it over on Twitch, on my Twitch streams. So if you don't follow me on Twitch, go ahead and follow me, twitch.tv/DTJoel. I've been streaming a lot more recently, especially playing this deck and D-Reaper. So if you're interested in seeing gameplay of that, then go ahead and follow me on there. And I'm actually going to go ahead and attach one of my gameplay gameplay clips from one of my most recent streams playing this green hybrid deck against my friend and friend of the channel, MBBTCG. We're gonna go play green hybrid versus Massimon. You're gonna see how strong this deck can be into a tier one deck. All right, guys, so that's gonna be it from me. Go ahead and stay tuned for the gameplay. Otherwise, I will see you guys in the next video, and GG's. Hatch. Terriermon draw, and we'll go JP. Go ahead.
Hatch Demimera.
Yep.
Going to Psychmon.
Yep.
Draw. Duty 4. Go to Magna. Okay.
Draw. Raise. Rapid for 3. Swing over the Magna. And green boost. 1, 2, 3, 4. Taking the Beetlemon.
Okay. Draw. Purple boost. Mm-hmm. Yeah. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. Grab the Maste.
Yep.
Go ahead.
Draw for turn, unsuspend, Argomon, gain a memory. Mm-hmm. Match. Swing 6,000 at security.
4,000.
Okay.
It was Gato.
Let's go into Beetle for 1. Draw effects. 4, 5, take the other Beetle. HPD on top, Terrier, which should be weenie. Let's see. Pop boost, go to 3. And play Mimi, put you to 1.
Okay, sounds good. Draw, play Gato, give you 4. Gato effect. Yep. 1, 2, 3. We're going to add the Lucemon.
Okay. Draw. Unsuspend, gain a memory. Green boost, go to 2.
Joel, your green deck is actually pretty good with that rapid mod.
Take the Rhino. Swing 5,000 at security.
Okay, check 2.
Yep. Swing 6,000 at security.
Degrade. Let's do it on the rapid.
Sure. Top or bottom? Oh, it just goes. You're right.
No. I say top or bottom, but you just don't trash.
Okay.
Let's put it up bottom. Sure.
So it's dead. And then JP put you to 1.
Okay. Draw. Let Hellscythe kill the thing. It's 6,000, right?
Yeah, it's 5,000, so yeah.
Yeah, bring up Magna, heal with Magna.
Okay.
Go ahead, you're 5.
Yep. Draw. JP and the Beetle for 1. Draw. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Take the Metal Kabu. Let's go to the bottom. Digivolve into Metal Kabu for 1. Draw. Suspend the Magna. Digivolve into Rhino for 1. Draw. Pop boost. Go to 4. And then Nidhogg your board.
Alright, they go to the bottom at 1, yep. Correct?
Go ahead.
Alright, draw. Promote swing security.
Z,
let's make another Gato, put you at 4. 1, 2, 3, let's add Lady Devi and Maste.
Okay. Unsuspend. Play Terriermon. Draw. Tap Mimi, bring it out. Rapid for 3. Draw. Tap Izzy to gain a memory.
Board's wiped, yeah.
Card. Yeah, board's wiped.
Draw 1, discard.
Yeah.
Draw. I'll discard a Lucemon Chaos Mode.
Swing 6,000, or sorry, 8,000 at security.
Defeat.
Okay. Swing 13 at security.
6.
Okay. And we'll go with... we'll go with JP, put you to 1.
JP put me to 1. How am I at 1? I thought I went to 1 memory.
I was at...
Izzy gave you a memory. Yeah. Izzy gave you a memory.
Yeah. Yep.
Draw. Attach. Go into Psychmon. Draw. You have a memory tamer, correct?
Yeah, Mimi's out.
Zwart Defeat will crash into the Nidhogg and then pop the Armor Purge. I'm going to play Calling for one. We will add Gato, and we're going to add yeah, we'll just add two Gatos. And then just Digivolve for three into Gato, your turn.
Draw, how many secure you have?
I have two.
Two. Digivolve into Terriermon, draw. Swing security.
Okay, check a health scythe. Kill the terrier. The best thing I could bring out is the Gauzy.
Okay. Did you open the Beetlemon for one?
Mm-hmm.
Draw effect. Two, three, four, five. Take the Metal Kabu.
Mm-hmm.
Swing security.
Check six.
Okay, and then Metal Kabu for game.
Yep. Ugh, the Nidhogg sucked.
Nidhogg's still broken.
I misplayed. I should have just sat on my board, not swung at your security.